Once again, a happy morning to one and all. I welcome you all to this second digital transformation webinar in this VAT webinar series titled How to Get Your SAP System Ready with Oman VAT Regulations that will be hosted by Car Technologies LLC, a premium SAP partner in the Gulf Cooperation Council. Oman is today ready to implement value-added tax from the 1st of April 2021. And the basic requirement to get SAP ready for VAT is to tune your ERP system to comply with the VAT regimes. Hence, today, enterprises have to prepare themselves for the new regulations and take the necessary steps for embracing this change. And today we have gathered, and we at CarTech have a panel of dedicated VAT experts. And today we have gathered here to present this webinar, which will also cover a plethora of information that will be most relevant for your business today. Introducing the speakers for the webinar, I have Mr. Santosh, the head of global marketing, representing our country head of Oman, Mr. Mahesh, due to an unforeseen medical emergency. And I have Mr. Dhanashekaran, the finance solution expert, who has a 10 plus years of experience in consulting. And he has also handled 15 plus VAT projects in KSA in UAE. I have Ms. Meghla. She's the associate practice lead of the SAP Logistics BuySite. She also has an experience of 7 plus years of SAP consulting and 5 plus implementation experiences across ECC HANA globally. And she's also handled multiple support projects. And I have Ms. Shubhangi, who's been with CAR for the past 5 years, and she's also a SD and service module expert. She's also played a vital role in handling a number of S4HANA implementations and also a number of other VAT implementations in KSA and UAE. So there will also be a system demo, live system demo, and an enriching Q&A session in the end. So participants and attendees, you can post in your questions in the question answer tab or the chat's window. And we'll get it answered right at the end. So sit back and enjoy this webinar. Over to you, Santosh.
Thank you, Anand. A warm welcome to everyone here. And thank you for taking your time on a working day to attend this webinar. This will be partly an awareness session about what regulations that the government is bringing into the change in the country and how the SAP system is enabling you to make sure that you are having a seamless experience in terms of having the VAT implementation rolled out. As introduced by Anand, I'm Santosh. I'm head of the marketing for the global marketing for Car Technologies. I used to be the P&L head for Oman, UAE, Qatar, and Kuwait until 2019. And later on, it was taken over by Mahesh Khanna. And he's heading the country at the moment as a P&L head. But unfortunately, because of certain medical emergencies, he's not able to make it. Not for him, but for his dad, I mean, who's going through a critical condition. So he's not able to make it to the presentation. I apologize for his absence on his behalf. And meanwhile, as Anand introduced, I mean, we have three major speakers. They are the experts in this area of discussion today. One is Meghla. I mean, she's the digital transformation advisor for us. And she's an SAP consultant for a long time, I mean, on the logistics side. And she is carrying a very immense experience, as Anand pointed out. And we have Shubhangi as well. She's also part of the digital transformation team and part of the SAP logistics team. And she's also a senior consultant with us with a reasonable experience on the SAP implementation side, including VAT as well. And of course, we have the finance expert, Dhanashekaran. He's also a digital transformation advisor, part of our SAP finance practice. And he comes with a very rich domain experience with all the regulations and conditions thoroughly understood. And he has helped a lot of customers implementing SAP Finance as well. So I'll not take much of a time for the introductory session because I know that, I mean, you have come here for a purpose, but it is my bounded duty to give you a brief introduction about Car Technologies as a company. And among the attendees, there are certain existing customers of ours, attending this webinar. They may be knowing us, but for the benefit of the others who may not be knowing Car Technologies, I would like to quickly introduce this, our company. So we were founded in 2006, and we have having more than 1.5 decades of experience in the SAP arena. And we are a pure play SAP company, and we are the largest pure play company headquartered in India and operating in the GCC. We are one among the largest pure play companies in the GCC, and we are one of the very strongest SAP partners in the GCC region. We have our presence across the GCC, including KSA, Qatar, Oman, UAE, Kuwait, and Bahrain as well. And we have close to 5,500 man years of SAP expertise, which is very, very, very impressive when compared to any other SAP companies in the region. And we have executed more than 2,000 plus projects in GCC alone, with more than 300 global SAP marquee customers. And majority of our consultants, close to 75% of our SAP consultant workforce, is certified officially by SAP. And we have 13 global locations. GCC is the primary region that we operate with them. And we are also present in North America and partly in Europe, in UK and in the Netherlands. And we are also present in the Asia-Pacific region as well. Though we are headquartered in India, apart from the operations and the offshore development center, we don't have major customers in India, but we focus on outside of India. As we speak about the pure play nature, we are an SAP service and award partnership. I mean, we hold the highest partnership in the region, which is the Gold Partnership. And we have more than 50 plus customers on the support, SAP support. We are supporting more than 50 customers, and they have been repeatedly renewing the contracts with us. And there is no precedent of any of the customers leaving us after we starting to provide them support. And if you look at the verticals, we are a horizontal player. As I told, we are a pure play player, and we keep abreast with the latest happenings in SAP. Otherwise, I mean, we know that we'll be lagging in the race. So anything which is new on SAP, we take it head on, and we have the commitment from the management is immense in terms of setting up the new practice whenever SAP comes up with a new technology. Anything on the cloud, anything on the beyond edge technologies, including the machine language, the deep, the artificial intelligence, the machine language, and also when it comes to RPA and even IoT as well. So we keep abreast with the latest happenings, whether it is on the front end or at the UI level or at the back end as well. So since we are a horizontal player, the verticals that we take on is oil and gas predominantly, being in the GCC region, and the manufacturing, the public sector, the government projects, especially in KSA. And we deal with conglomerates. I mean, so that is one of the sweet spots for us. And we have mastered the art of implementing to multiple entities in multiple locations. You know, so we have done a lot of SAP end-to-end S4 implementations for the conglomerates, including in Oman. And manufacturing, of course, both the process manufacturing and the discrete manufacturing is something that we have dealt with. And the wholesale distribution in the retail segment, and engineering and construction, banking and the financial services industries. And of course, the retail also comes under the wholesale distribution as well. So that is something. And if you look at the recognitions that we talk about, I mean, these are the recognitions which is provided to our own customers who have implemented SAP, and for whom we have helped them implement SAP. So the quality awards, I'm sure, I mean, coming from an SAP background, you all know what is this quality awards is all about. So this speaks volumes about the quality of the delivery that we make. If you look from 2010 until 2019, consecutively, we have been winning awards for the customers where we have implemented SAP. So that speaks volumes about the delivery. And in fact, last year, we managed to get an award at the EMEA level as well. So meaning, I mean, we have won two awards in the MENA, and one of them got qualified in the EMEA, and we got an award at the EMEA level as well. So it takes a lot of prominence because we are more of a delivery-based organization. That's the point I'm trying to drive. More than a sales organization, we are a delivery-based organization because we depend only on SAP. So our word of mouth is on based on the best customers, the good experienced customers, the customers having a better experience with us. They are the ones who propagate our name in the market. So we wanted to tell you that, I mean, more than a sales organization, we are more of a delivery organization. So that's a brief nutshell about our company. Anant, move on. So again, as I indicated, I mean, we have consecutively won the quality awards starting from 2010. And these names are not new for us. I don't want to go one by one. And these are all the greatest SAP names in the GCC region. Starting from 2010, if you look at the Consolidated Can Manufacturing Company in 2011, it is a public sector company, I guess. And in 2013, again, that's a public sector company. In 2014, it's the Military Industries Corporation in Saudi Arabia and ADCO. And in 2015, is Al Karian Group and the Arabian Gulf University in Bahrain. And in 2006, again, the Romana and Oasis Manufacturing, I guess, the water company. And in 2018, you see, I mean, there are three categories which we have gone apart. One in from Ara and Karat Mill in Oman itself, and SIDF, which is the largest industrial development fund in Saudi Arabia. And Oman OAS is again another water manufacturing company in Oman. And in 2019, again, SIDF has got an award, and SGS, the Saudi Ground Services, has got an award. So this speaks volumes about the quality of the delivery that we have been doing in this region. Yes, move on, Anand. So again, this webinar, since it is specific to Oman region, I just wanted to give you a glimpse of who are all the major customers that we are dealing with. This is not limited to this. So these are all the major names that we are dealing with in the SAP arena within the Oman as a country. And Ara Petroleum is a petroleum company. Karat Mil Petroleum, again, another petroleum company. We implemented S4HANA end-to-end implementations for them. And OYAS is, again, a food and beverage company as part of the Zubair Group. And we implemented S4HANA end-to-end. And Oman Gas, again, this is now part of the Orpik. And Oman Gas, I mean, they had a kind of a failed implementation, which we took over, and then we resurrected that. And we did the entire ECC implementation. Re-implementation was done in Oman Gas, and we supported them. And we are continuing to support as well as part of Orpik. And Oman Cement Manufacturing, we are supporting their SAP landscape. And Strobo also, you know, there was a kind of a re-implementation which was done by us, and we are supporting the system even now. And Oman Methanol Company, where we have implemented the SAP Environmental Health and Safety module. And Oman Aluminium Rolling Company, again, an end-to-end implementation on ECC, and we are continuing to support them. And PowerTech also, we are supporting them. And Orpik, we have continued support for many years now. And MHD, Mohsin Hyde Dawish, that's a conglomerate with the multiple legal entities in different locations. We are implementing S4HANA for them. And Salalah Methanol, again, we are supporting them. And Abraj Services, we are supporting their SAP system. And Oman Steel as well. That was also a resurrection project. And we are supporting their Oman Steel SAP landscape. So this will give you a feel of, you know, what is the kind of presence that we are having across the spectrum of the Oman-based customers. So I'm sure, I mean, you'll be able to connect with this. With this brief introduction, I would like to move on to the crux of the session, which is the webinar on VAT, over to, you know, other speakers. And before that, I would like to touch upon the VAT customers that we have been implementing in the GCC region. This is not limited to Oman, but Oman, we are yet to start the VAT implementation. You know that VAT as a regulation itself is just coming on. So we have implemented more than 30 plus VAT implementations in the GCC region, and that is across KSA and UAE. And if you look at all these customers, ATCO, Al-Kuzama, Al-Karayan Group, Bitumart, Al-Manzuri Engineering Services, Konara Steel in UAE, Al-Manzuri is also in UAE, Inbisco, NAFSL, Can End Manufacturing Limited, Sigma Paints in Saudi Arabia, and Saudi Cargo, which is the Saudi Ground Services, and the Samref is another subsidiary of Aramco, which is a refinery company based out of Saudi, and Lubref is also in another petrol chemical industry, Al Qatani Holding, PSI, and Tanmiya Group. And these are all the customers where we have SEPCO. These are all the customers that we have implemented SAP VAT in a couple of years before. And we are looking forward to, you know, extend that VAT expertise to the customers in Oman as well. So with this quick nutshell briefing about the company, I would like to have the other speakers take over, which is the interesting part of this webinar now. So over to you, Meghala, for you to take over. Thank you so much.
Yeah, thank you, Santosh. Yeah. Good morning, everyone. Yeah, Anand, can you move the slide? Yeah, okay, thanks. Yeah, let us start with a quick overview about the Oman VAT. As you all know, Oman is likely to introduce the VAT effective from April 21 at the standard rate of 5%. And we also know that regulation has been passed in the December 2020, and we are expecting few more details about the law in the upcoming weeks. And also, Oman could be the fourth GCC member state, followed by Saudi Arabia, UAE, and Bahrain to implement the VAT. Next, please. Okay. These are the five key areas for the VAT readiness for any company. Example, the first could be the VAT treatment of sales and purchases. So we need to make the system readiness for the VAT with respect to the sales cycle and the procurement cycle. This could be the first point. And coming to the second point is the contracts and pricing. Okay, there could be some pricing configuration changes. There should be additional condition types to be included with respect to VAT in the contracts and the pricing procedures for the procurements. And coming to the third is the accounting system. Yes, there could be additional VAT relevant accounting system in place after the implementation, which we need to make the system ready. And the fourth could be the invoicing. Invoicing is of course the legal requirement. So any invoicing, any sales invoice, it has to hit the VAT. The VAT entering should be in place. And also in the invoicing forms, the VAT relevant details are mandatory. And coming to the fifth one is the VAT return form. So to submit the VAT return form to the government, we have to make the system readiness for the VAT form in the SAP system. So these are all the five key areas for any existing customer should make the system ready to adapt the scenarios, VAT relevant scenarios in place. Okay, the second could be the, now coming to the VAT calculation. Okay, the VAT calculation is applicable for all the goods and services. So it is further divided into two categories. One could be the exempted supplies and the other could be the taxable supplies. Under taxable supplies, we have two rates, that is zero rate and the another one is standard rate, that is nothing but 5%. Okay, now let us have a quick overview about the zero rated supplies. What are all the supplies which falls under zero rated as per the Oman VAT law? Okay, the supplies like certain food products, like certain medicines and medical equipments, and supplies of investments on gold, silver, and platinums, and other supplies like oil, oil derivatives, and natural diesel, and the remaining, whatever mentioned in this particular site, these are all falls under zero rated as per the law, as per the Oman VAT law. Next. Yeah, now coming to the exempted category. Okay, so there are certain services like financial services, healthcare services, educational services, and like resale of residential properties, rental of properties, local passengers, transport. These are all listed in the exempted categories of VAT. So all the supplies and the services which are mentioned in the zero rated and the exempted, remaining all the supplies of goods and service will fall under the 5% of standard rate in Oman. Next, please. Okay, now coming to the main part, that is the input tax code. The input tax code is nothing but the tax code which has to be used during the procurement cycle. So any incoming procurements, we call it as input tax. For the tax codes for sales, we call it as output tax. Okay, here it is again divided into three sections. One is standard, exempted, and the third one is zero rated. Okay, what are all the tax code falls under standard? That is V2, V4, VX and VY. V2 and V4 is for domestic procurements. So V2 is 5% you have to use for the domestic goods purchases. And V4 is 5% again for services, domestic service procurements. And VX and VY is for the import. Especially VX is called reverse charge. So any procurements of services within GCC, it calls for reverse charge for goods and services. So we have to use the VX tax code. And VY, any procurements are made outside GCC, which calls for the 5% on top of customs. That's why we call it as a separate tax code is for VY. So these tax code has to be chosen during the purchase order creation screen. Those can be seen during the demo. We can see where it can be used. This tax code has to be chosen. And coming to the exempted, any procuring materials or goods or services which falls under exempted category, then we have to choose V0 tax code. And coming to the zero rated, as I told earlier in the earlier slides, there are certain supplies and certain services fall under zero rated. So for zero rated, for domestic services and goods, we have to use V1 and V3 tax codes respectively. Okay, over to Shubhangi for the output tax codes.
Good morning. For like the input tax codes that we just saw, we have a set of tax codes which will be available for the Oman in the standard itself after implementing the respective notes. So we will have all these tax codes in the system. So like the input tax codes, which is applicable for the purchase side, we have a certain set of tax codes which are applicable for the sales transactions as well. So those tax codes also falls under the three categories, which are the standard, exempt, and zero rated. So any supply of goods or the services which happen domestically will have the tax code S2 and S4 respectively. any goods or service supplied to the customer which falls under the category called exempted will have the tax code S0 and it will have a VAT value of zero. So the tax codes falling, the supply of goods and services which fall under the zero rated will majorly be the export. Be it the export inside the GCC or a non-GCC country will have the tax, will have the VAT rate of zero and it will have the tax codes S5, S6, S7 and S8 respectively. I think you'll be able to see in the screen flashed. The S1 and S3 tax codes are for the domestic supply of goods and services which fall under the zero rated category. So all these tax codes will be applied to the sales order, right from the sales order to the invoicing transactions automatically. We will set the condition records in the system appropriately so that when you create the transactions, all these tax codes will be picked automatically and respective accounting entries will be posted. So this setting up of condition records is to avoid the end user intervention when creating any sales order or any transaction. So the flow will be automatic. So the just the accounting entries will differ based upon the tax codes which are applied to the transactions. Next, please. Yes. So this is a general overview of how the accounting entries will look like from the procurement perspective. When applied with a tax code of zero rate or an exemption category, the accounting entries will remain the same. That is, the GRIR account will be debited and the vendor account will be credited. In addition to the accounting entries, you will have the tax code in place. This is for reporting and various analysis purposes. So just from the accounting entry, we'll be able to differentiate if it falls under the exempted or if it's an export or any other category. It can be identified just from the accounting entry itself. So for the standard 5% import or any procurement that happens at the rate of 5%, it will have the VAT receivable account in addition to the GRIR account. It will be debited. And it will also hold the SAP VAT tax codes in the accounting line item. Next slide, please. So this is the overview of the sales transaction which will be posted. So as mentioned previously, the zero rated tax code and the exempted tax will not have any change in the accounting entry values, but it will hold the tax codes. The respective tax code will be picked up from the transaction and it will be applied to the accounting entry for the differentiation purpose, for analysis or for the reporting purpose. For the standard rate at 5%, any supply that happens at the rate of 5% will have the VAT payable account credited along with the revenue account. And this will also hold the respective tax code in the accounting entry. So once the VAT is implemented into the system, we will have to do some changes into our master data and into our transaction data as a prerequisite or as a areas of impact. So in the customer master and in the vendor master data, we will have to upload the VAT registration numbers. So before we go live with VAT, before we start the transactions, we have to get all the VAT registration numbers from all the business partners that are involved in the business, be it vendor or the customer. And this will be uploaded as a mass upload activity during the implementation phase. Also, the address details and other details, the name, the contact details, and the address details should be uploaded in Arabic, because for many of the VAT invoice forms, a bilingual invoice form is required. So we'll have to do all the address uploading in the Arabic language into the system. So the tax classification indicator also has to be set up in both the customer master and the material master. Tax classification indicator determines if the customer or if the material is zero rated, falls under the zero rated category, an exempt category, or a standard rate of 5% category. So to do that identification, we have something called as a tax classification indicator. So that has to be set up in the customer master and in the material master. So as previously mentioned, for any transaction to pick up the tax code, we have to set up the output condition records so that when creating any sales transaction, the tax codes will be picked up automatically. And also in all the existing GL masters and all the GL records, we have to enable the tax category for the accounting entry to hold the tax code. And in the PO form also, we might have to include some details like the tax code, the percentage of the tax which is applied for any import, the VAT value, and there might be some corrections in the PO output form as well. We'll see that form in the coming session. So the customer invoice form should also be made as a bilingual form, which is a prerequisite. Apart from this, we will also have to do the VAT tax classification indicator update in any open sales orders which is existing in the system the day before we go live with VAT. So that also should be done. Next slide, please. Yeah, so after implementation of the VAT, we will be requiring some reports to do the analysis to see the number of purchase transactions, all the sales transactions which are happened with the different tax codes. So this is a purchase VAT report, which is a custom report which we provide for our customers while implementing the VAT. So this will have details of all the vendor invoices with the vendor details, the vendor's tax VAT registration number. For any vendor invoice, what is the amount of VAT which is applied and what is the tax code which is applied? So all these details will be available in this custom report. So this report can be extracted periodically or on a day-on-day basis to do the analysis. Similar to this purchase VAT report, we have another report for the sales transactions as well. Next slide, please. So this is the VAT output report, which will have all the output tax codes. That is nothing but the customer invoice details. So this will have the customer name, the customer's VAT registration number, the value of the invoice with VAT and without VAT, and the tax code details. So this will be available. So this will also be very helpful in the analysis purpose of all the customer invoices which are generated in the system, and with the VAT tax code which is applied to all these invoices. So this can be analyzed through this report. So we have a sample invoice, which this invoice and all the details which are mentioned here was a prerequisite for implementing VAT in the KSA. So similarly, we will have one for Oman as well. So basically, the entire customer invoice was made into a bilingual format. So all the details of the customer, the VAT registration number, the date of supply, the invoice value with VAT, without VAT. So everything should be visible in both English and in the Arabic. So this was a prerequisite. So the details like the date of invoice issue, the supplier tax identification number, the customer name and the address should be made bilingual, the date of supply, the tax rate, and all the other details should be available in the invoice template. So definitely the invoice form which is existing in the system has to be reworked, and a new invoice form has to be built with all the informations which are provided.
Yeah, actually, this is the sample VAT return form which is introduced by KSA government. Okay, if you see in the right hand side, we can see all the your input tax and the output tax, and the further classification also there. In the output tax, you can see the zero rate or export or VAT exempted, and in the left hand side, you can see the tax base amount as well as the VAT amount. So similar kind of details are available for the input tax as well, zero rated, exempted, what is your reverse charge taxes, as well as within GCC, what is your tax base amount and what is your VAT amount. So the similar kind of format is available for UAE, and the same kind of format we are expecting for Oman as well. Next slide, please. And these are all the standard reports which is available already in the system, which will be used to analyze all your tax related accounting entries, the tax adjustment or the crash company code taxes or the advance return. So by using this standard reports, we can analyze all your VAT related entries. Next slide, please. Okay. When we implement VAT, definitely we are going to have some transactional issues. Okay, whether the VAT will be applicable for down payment or not, and how the VAT is going to be going to have impacted in your imports, and what is the reverse charge mechanism and which kind of supplies will falls under reverse charge mechanism, and how this intercompany invoicing is going to be affected, and what is the invoice which you are going to create for the contract which has been created before this VAT introduction. So we will go one by one. Okay, when we talk this down payment, which is nothing but the advance payment, the two different key elements which decide whether that particular transaction is falls under VAT or not. Okay, first one, VAT invoice. Okay, the invoice date in the invoice date is going to be decided. Okay, if the invoice date is before the key date, then there is no VAT for that particular advance payment. If the invoice date is after the key date, then we are with that VAT is going to be applied on that particular advance transaction. Similarly, the posting date of advance payment. Okay, if the posting date of advance payment is before the key date, then in that case, there is no VAT. If it is after the key date, then we should apply the VAT on that particular transaction. Similarly, for imports, okay. Till now, in customs, we will pay only the custom duty. Going forward, I mean, once the VAT is there in the place, then we have to pay the VAT. Okay, the customs will calculate the VAT on the assessable value. The material value can be differ and the tax base amount can be differ. So in SAP, while posting this custom invoices, so there is a special field called accessible value. This particular field will be enabled by applying a couple of notices. So whenever you are posting the invoices for the custom authority, so there is the field called accessible value will be enabled. And you can enter this accessible value, and the VAT will be applied on those particular accessible value. Similarly, a reverse charge mechanism for all your services and goods imported within GCC will fall under a reverse charge mechanism. Both your input tax account and the output tax account will get hit when we choose this reverse charge mechanism. And the next one is this intercompany invoicing. When we post this intercompany invoicing, usually in SAP by standard, the VAT will get posted in the first entity only. So we have to transfer this VAT VAT to the respective the legal entity too. So in SAP, we do have the standard program is available, which will be used to transfer this VAT from the legal entity one to legal entity two. So assume that we do have the single vendor, and the single vendor will issue invoices. So the instead of legal entity, entity one is going to make the payment. In that case, the VAT will be there in the legal entity one only. So we have to transfer this VAT impact to the legal entity to take the credit. So that is by standard, it is possible, and we do have the special program that can be used. And the last one is the contract. Okay, according to the UAE law, the contract which has been created before the key date is called a silent contract. That means the invoice for those contracts, there is no VAT. Similarly, for KSA, when they increase the VAT, okay, because of this COVID, from 5% to 15%, the contract which has been created before 11th May, there is 5% VAT, and the contract which has been created after 11th May falls under 15% category. So similar kind of guidelines we may expect from Oman government as well. Yeah, next slide, please. And before going to this roadmap and activities, we can quickly go through the system, and we can have this some small demo. Yeah, over to you, Meghla.
Yeah, thank you, Dana.
So this is a live system demo that we are showing with one of our demo systems. I hope this will be interesting for you all. And please keep raising the questions either in the Q&A tab or on the chat tab. And towards the end of the session, we will answer all the questions.
Thank you, Santosh.
Okay. Go ahead.
Yeah, coming here, this is a procurement scene. Hope you all know this is the purchase order creation screen. We'll just see what are all the impacts.
Meghla, sorry to interrupt. Meghla, there are it's a mixed set of people available here. There are people who has XAP experience and people without XAP system. So you need to consider both while doing the demo, please.
Yeah, thank you. Yeah, fine.
Thanks, okay. Bye.
Yeah, fine. Okay, this is the system, SAP system, where we used to create a purchase order creation in this screen. Earlier, before implementation of VAT, there will be no field called tax code that is in the item overview screen. You can see in the invoicing tab, you can see the tax code field. Yeah, this tax code earlier before implementing VAT, it will not be a mandatory field and it is no need to input this field. But after implementation of VAT, when you are creating any purchase order, this field will be made mandatory. So you have to choose the respective tax code as per the law, which means, as I told earlier, if it is 0%, you have to choose 0%. If it's 5%, you have to choose 5%. So in the F4 option, F4 is nothing but a search option where you will be listed all the input tax. So you can choose the applicable tax code has to be chosen here. This could be the first impact. And second, can you go to the conditions? Yeah, the conditions is nothing but the flow of condition types from the pricing procedure. So what are all the additional costs? Like for any procurement, there will be additional costs like freight, if there is customs, if it is import. So there could be some additional cost. So here, there will be one more condition type called JEXS, which is nothing but the standard condition type for VAT. So it will be in place after the VAT implementation. Here it is zero SAR because we have chosen zero tax code. Similarly, if you have chosen 5%, the 5% will be calculated here automatically in the pricing procedure. Okay, so once these two fields, like automatically when you choose the tax code, the pricing procedure will be reflected automatically, then it has to be reflect in the printout. This is one of the sample printout which we need to show you. In when you are doing implementation KSA, we have included all these VAT relevant details in the purchase order print form. The two key things, one is customer side, that is customer side VAT number, that is the our VAT number. Client side VAT number and the vendor VAT number, it should be included in the existing purchase order form. And on top of it, the item level, we need to include the VAT percentage and the VAT amount. It is also mandatory for all item level, the VAT percentage has to be included. So these are all the changes and the impact which will take place after the implementation from the procurement side. And coming to the VAT report, this is one of the sample VAT report which we developed for KSA. So we like to show you how this report works. Okay, for this VAT report is for MM side, that is all procurement cycles, all the procurement. Yes, please. Yeah. This particular VAT report has the PO number and the relevant invoice details along with the VAT and the VAT amount. So in a single report, you will be able to see from the PO until invoice, inclusive of VAT, whether it is a down payment or it is a normal invoice, all the relevant details will be brought in this report. It can be in both English and Arabic. This report has works on both English and Arabic. Over to you, Subhangi.
Yeah, moving on, we have the VAT impacts in the sales and distribution transactions as well. So this is a sample sales order. So when the VAT is live and when the condition records are set, any sales line item will have the condition type called ZVAT. So it will have another condition type for the output VAT. So here we have applied a 5% VAT. So in addition to the net amount for the line item, the tax amount will also be visible. So the tax code will be seen here. So the tax code will pick automatically from the condition records, which is maintained in the system. So in the sales order itself, you will be able to see the output tax, which is applied for each line item. And the tax code which is applied also will flow automatically. So you need not enter the tax percentage here manually, it will flow automatically based upon the customer and the material which is used. So this can differ line item wise also, because some materials will be zero rated, some materials will have a standard rate of 5%. So the tax percentage will pick automatically based upon the condition records which we have set in the system. So when this sales order is invoiced also, the condition records will flow automatically. It will copy from the sales order and it will be visible in the invoice line items with the tax code. So the accounting entry also will show. So this accounting entry will have the VAT receivable account in addition. So when we take printout of this invoice, it will look like this. So it will be a complete bilingual output form. It will have the 5% VAT amount also, and it will have the grand total and the subtotal also. So all these are the mandatory information. In addition, we'll have the VAT registration number of the customer and the company. So we have provision for all of that. So once maintained in the material master, all these information will flow automatically to the invoice form. So we have to design an invoice form which holds both the English and the Arabic with the subtotal, the grand total, and the VAT percentage which is applied with the VAT amount which the customer has to pay. So all these detail has to be shown in the output form. So we'd like to show the output VAT report also. So this is the output VAT report. This can be executed periodically. It can also have the tax code. You can also execute this report with the tax code for a particular sold to party, for a particular material, or for a particular billing document. So we can add any number of selection parameters depending upon the requirement. So this is how the output of the report will look like. It will show the invoice date, the invoice number, the country, the document types, and the other details. So this is an itemized report. So it will contain all the items. And for each item, it can it will display the tax code which is applied, the rate, the value of the tax, I mean, the tax value and the invoice value. The total value will also be displayed. So all the details will be available in the report. So any sales transaction, you'll be able to find out from this report. It can be executed periodically, and various analysis can be done by applying filters to these tax codes, which is there. So moving on, we have the VAT return form, Dana.
Yeah, this is the VAT return form which we have showed just now in the PPT. So this is the period wise. It is mandatory to submit the VAT return form to the government. So it has the all the details which we have seen just now in the PPT. So it is the period wise report, and it can be generated. And one more thing, this is the custom developed form. So as part of deliverable, we are going to deliver this particular form as well. Yeah. Next one, and Ananda, can you please go to the PPT? Yeah, Meghla, over to you.
Yeah, thank you, Dana. Okay, coming to the implementation roadmap and activities. So here as a company, we for any implementation, we used to follow activate methodology. Similarly, for the VAT implementation also, we'll be following the activate methodology. So let me have a quick overview on the implementation roadmap. The first could be the impact analysis. For VAT, the first thing which we do, it's the impact study. That could be the first stage. And second could be the solution design. The third could be the realization, where we do the all kind of configuration and system setup. And the fourth could be the final preparation for the system readiness for the live. And fifth could be the live. So the next slide, we can see the detailed plan for the project plan for the VAT implementation, where we have 8 weeks, that is nothing but the 2 months timeline for the VAT implementation for the Oman region. So we have completely equipped, we have a complete equipped team who have already have experience with the KSA VAT. So they can do the complete implementation for one set of company code for 2 months of period. Considering the volume of the legal entity, the timeline may vary, but we are committed to deliver the implementation project in 8 weeks, that is nothing but 2 weeks. sorry, 2 months. So now it's a detailed week-wise plan. Here on week one, we'll be doing the requirement analysis. So here, as I told earlier, first we'll be completely analyzing the impact in the current system with respect to VAT. That'll be the first activity. So we will be checking what are all the existing reports to be changed, what are all the existing forms to be changed, and what are the new reports to be developed, like any legal VAT requirements are there. We have to find out that in the requirement analysis phase in the first week. And week two will be for the blueprint, which we call it as solution design document, where based on the analysis, we'll be preparing a document, which is kind of blueprint document from all the core three modules, that is MM, SD, and finance side. So we'll be developing an report. We'll be preparing the blueprint document, and the respective blueprint document will be reviewed with the respective business process owners. That could be the week two activity. And week three activity comes to the review with the business on the document, and the sign off will take place accordingly in the week three. And week four is the where the key activity will be implementing the SAP note, which is released by the SAP for VAT. So we'll be first implementing that standard SAP note. On top of it, we'll be doing some configuration changes in all three modules like finance, SD, and MM. So that realization starts in the week four. Next, please. And week five, where we need to do the additional report developments, as I told earlier, any form developments, all the business process testing, which we done in the week four, all activities will be taken place in the week five. And week six is mainly for the training. So for all the training activity to the key users will be done in week six. And any material master maintenance with respect to VAT, all those will be taken care in the week six. And week seven is for the UAT, that is nothing but user acceptance testing for the VAT implemented processes. And the TR movement for the production system readiness will be taken place in week seven, and week eight is for the go live. So this is the detailed plan for VAT implementation from our side to commit this live. Over to you, Santosh, if you want to add something.
No, that's pretty much from our side. Meghala, thank you so much. Shubhangi, Dhanashekar, thank you for a detailed explanation. I'm sure the audience will have certain questions. They have already posted questions in the Q&A box and in the chat. So what I can do is, Anant, would you like to go through, or should I take it one by one to have people answer it?
Yeah, Satosh. We have some questions in the question box as well as the chat window as well. So I'll first go through this question from Mr. Shane D'Souza. He's asked whether is the tax applicable to all invoices after implementation, or is it similar to KSA, wherein if the contract was prior to VAT, then the invoices or contract falls under VAT exemption. How does it, can somebody answer this question?
Yeah, okay. I think hope Shane is from MHD, I believe. Yeah, Shane, as Dana has already answered to this question, I believe there will be a cutoff date. As Dana said earlier, there will be a cutoff date. If the contract falls after that cutoff date, it is applicable for VAT. So we have to wait and see the date from the Oman government. Dana, you would like to add something on top of it financially?
No, that's fine,
Michael. Okay. So I'll go to the next question. It is from Mr. Suman. Is the master code of tax will be created type? Master code of tax will be created type of material and service specific or vendor specific, like some of the vendor and material exempt or zero rated?
Okay. I think this is relevant to the condition type.
Yep, condition type.
Yeah, okay. Yes, Suman, with the condition types, we'll be maintaining this percentage so that automatically it can be fletched during the sales orders.
Okay, so there's another question from him. He's not seen any advance payment reference in the tax invoice that we have shown. Will that be required in case of any advance review, or we need to generate this tax invoice and in final invoice, the reference of advance invoice should be there? How is that?
Okay, hope Dana, can you step in for it with respect to advance payment?
Yeah, again, it is based on this date only, Meghla. So if the advance is, after the key date, then definitely VAT is going to be there. Oh. And in the invoice also, we need to prepare the invoice also.
Okay, Mr. Sanjeev Madhavi has asked, can the implementation timelines to be shrunk to 4 weeks? How is that possible?
Anand, before moving to question, please check with the person who has asked the question whether this is convincing or do they have any clarifications around that still.
Yeah, I will do that, Santosh.
Okay, go ahead.
Yeah, so can the implementation timeline be shrunk to 4 weeks? Is the question from Mr. Sanjeev. Can somebody answer this?
I'll take it up. Sanjeev, see, ideally speaking, the 8 weeks is the best recommended way to go about the VAT implementation because, you know, for any SAP implementation, however small or big, it has to go through the process and it has to go through the methodology. And we cannot take a shortcut on this. Taking a shortcut will prove detrimental to the whole scheme of things. So we believe that 8 weeks is a decent timeline. But still, I mean, if at all, you know, if you are interested to explore the, you know, the options with us, we can have a discussion offline and see what is the best could be done, which will suit your organization. We are open for a discussion. But ideal timelines that we are looking at is 8 weeks, and that is not luxurious, if you think so. It is not that.
Thanks, Santosh. Hope that answered your question, Mr. Sanjeev. So he's also asked one more question. What new dashboards and KPIs are required by the organization to address this introduction of VAT? Can somebody answer that?
Okay. With respect to KPIs, it has to be set by the business. So they have to say what kind of KPIs they are expecting for the VAT dashboards. So maybe they can further consider the VAT legal requirements of Oman. Accordingly, they can develop the dashboards.
Okay. So hope that answered your question, Mr. Sanjeev. So I'm going to the next question from Mr. Govinda Kiran Kamat. In case of Oman ODN number required, the Oman ODN number required is his question, if I understand it right. Can somebody answer this?
Yeah, let me answer this, Anand. Okay, in case of ODN number, we yet to receive instruction from government. We are not sure whether it is required or not, but we have to wait for government. Anand.
Okay, so there's one more question from, hope that answered your question, Mr. Govind. There's one more question from Mr. Suman Kumar. I think his question was different. He didn't mean the cutoff date. It was actually about the creation of invoice, whether the tax invoice will be raised.
Yes, sir. For advance. Yeah, for advance, yeah, we need to raise the invoices to the customers, Suman.
Okay. So, and there's one more question from Ms. Nishit Punja. It is, hi, will there be VAT applicable for online cloud-based services in Oman?
I mean, this point should be, we have to verify with the law. So are they asking whether VAT applicable for the those kind of services also falls under VAT? I think hope that is their question.
Yeah, so hope that answered your question. Can you be more specific, Mr. Nishit? So the next question from Mr. Suman is, his question is answered. So the next question is from Shane D'Souza from MSG. That is, does it work on the purchases as well, similar to his previous question?
Yeah, yes, Shane. I think your question is from which date the VAT is applicable. It is based on cutoff date only, Shane. There will be a cutoff date. So for any that beyond that cutoff date for purchasing invoices and sales invoices, the VAT is applicable.
Okay. So there's a question from Vishwanath in the chat that whether kindly confirm how VAT will be treated or accounted for purchases without PO or without impacting GRIR and vendor account.
For normal direct FI transactions, there also we do have provision to choose the respective tax codes. And while posting, we can choose the tax codes and we can post it.
Anand, there are previous questions also in the chat. You need to scroll up.
Yeah, I'm just seeing it, Santosh. There's a question from Mr. Shankar Datta for the output VAT. The VAT payable will depend on earlier of invoicing or payment or delivery. How does that work? How does your system track this and how does that work? So can somebody take this question?
Anand, would you please repeat the question?
Yeah, for output VAT, the VAT payable will depend on earlier of invoicing or payment or delivery. How does your system track this?
Okay, yeah. In case of output tax, during advances, we will post the VAT. And during invoices, Yes, the system itself will knock off the VAT. Knock off the VAT based on the amount. So the system will compare the total sale order value and the advance value, and the system will reduce the VAT from the invoice.
Okay. So there's also one more question. Hope that answered your question, Mr. Shankar. So there's also one more question from him, that what happens if the contract transcends the two periods?
Yeah, that's what. Okay. Say, for example, when we take this KSA example, okay, the contract which has been created after the 11th May, and for those contracts till 2021 May, there is no, the VAT is only 5%. So it all depends upon the law which we are going to, which the Oman government is going to announce. So according to UAE, contracts on silent mode. There is no VAT for the contract which has been created before the cutoff date. Okay. According to KSA, it is also same. Before the key date, if we have created the contract, those falls under 5% category. And if it is after the cutoff date, then it is the 15%.
Okay. Yeah, I hope that answered your question, Mr. Shankar. I'm going to the next question, that is from Mr. Shane. To be precise, if you have procured for materials after the VAT implementation, but then under a contract before the cutoff date, then is the VAT applicable?
Before the cutoff date, you mean, right? I could not see that question. Yeah.
Yes, it is in the,
No, see, it is on which date you do the invoice. So that is to be considered. The PO can be raised on now in January, but if you are doing invoice for the respective order after April, it will fall under VAT. So again, as Dana said earlier, if it has to be falls under exempted category, then we have to go through the law. If there is an exemption for those purchase orders which are created before this April, then that can be excluded.
Okay. So hope that answered your question, Mr. Shane. So I'm going to the next question, that is from Mr. Mudit Gupta, that is how VAT will be applicable for stock transfer between different companies of the group.
If both entities are registered separately, and then VAT will be applicable. If you are registering the invoice, then definitely VAT will be applicable, Mr. Mudit.
Okay. So he's also asked one more question. Hope that answered your question, Mudit. So whether VAT will be applicable for direct issue of multiple cost objects of different companies within the group?
Whether VAT will be applicable for direct issue of multiple cost object of different companies within the group? Yeah, this is, I think, the intercompany, cross-company postings. Yeah, definitely VAT will be applicable. So we do have the standard special program which will transfer the VAT will be the legal entity 1 to legal entity 2. Yeah, when we post this first transaction, the intercompany transaction, the VAT will get, where VAT will be calculated and it will be posted in the legal entity 1 only. We manually, we have to transfer that particular VAT to the legal entity 2.
So, yeah, also in the chat window, I'm seeing Mr. Sanjeev asking whether this was a wonderful session. Thank you, Sanjeev, and very insightful indeed. Thank you for that. And we'll also be sharing the slides presented. Yes, definitely we'll do that, and the recording as well, Mr. Sanjeev.
Yeah, we'll be sharing the slides, Sanjeev, and to all other participants as well. We will also share the video recording in a consumable format. And in meanwhile, Anant, in the Q&A, there is an answered session where you have answered that you will answer them during the Q&A. So there are a couple of questions there.
Yes, Santosh, I'm just having a look at it. And it is a question from Mr. Suman. I think we have answered it in the forum already. And the next question is from Mr. Amar Shah. He wants to know more on the fixed assets and how is it being treated in the VAT.
So, yeah, fixed assets also, okay, when you are procuring, okay, if in the invoice, if the VAT is there, yeah, definitely the VAT, we have to post the VAT and we have to pay it to the vendor. Similarly, for the sales side as well.
Okay. Okay, Mudit Gupta says it means we have to stop all stock transfer between companies and also issues between the companies. How does that work? Dana, can you answer that, please?
No. It is not required to stop it. Why? Because usually you will take this credit and all, right? So that will get knocked off.
Okay.
Yeah.
So I think we have answered all the open questions. So if there are any more questions, you can definitely post it attendees. So we'll definitely get it answered. So I think we have 5 more minutes. And yeah, there's a question from Mr. Amar Shah. Okay. For fixed assets, is its VAT credit to be availed over the number of years? How does he's just asked it in the chat group. Somebody can answer it.
Sorry, Anand, what is the question?
Yeah, it is actually not a question. He's typed a comment saying for fixed asset, it's VAT credit to be availed over the number of years.
Okay.
And also, Mr. Amar,
do you have a specific question on this? Or do you want to rephrase that?
Yeah, he's also asked one more question. That is, for fixed assets, he wants to know what kind of bifurcations are there for assets.
No, actually, still we don't have clarity on that from the government for the fixed asset classification. Okay, once we have the clarity, maybe. I mean, this has to be come from the Oman government.
Okay.
Amar Shah has clarified it. He has mentioned for fixed assets, it's VAT credit to be availed over the number of years. Input credit is not in the first year. It could be over number of years, that is 10 years. So it is a statement, I guess. There's no question around it. Dan Shagar, if you're able to interpret something out of it. Are you able to see the question?
Yes. We have to see the knocks from the government.
Okay.
Regarding this one, and this is fine. But
Okay. Meanwhile, we also have a question from Mr. Shane again. So I suppose my question was not clear. If you have a contract from the 1st December 2020, and the VAT is implemented from the 1st of April 2021, this assuming being the cutoff date as well for the VAT exemption. And we are invoicing on the 1st May 2021 for a particular milestone, but we are procuring for the second milestone on the 15th May 2021. Is this procurement being made VAT applicable or falls under VAT exemption, considering the contract is prior to the cutoff date? So, Dana, this question.
Yeah. Hello, Mr. Sin. Actually, here, since the contract creation date is before this VAT, so the invoices which you are creating after the VAT will not fall under VAT category. I mean, for those invoices, usually VAT will not be there. But anyhow, we need to wait for Oman government to clarify it further.
Okay, thanks, Dana, and attendees. If you have any more questions, you can post it in the question answer tab as well as the chat window. It is open for you guys.
Also, it would be great if you can leave your feedback as well, one-liner feedback in the chat window. Maybe, I mean, how did it go? I mean, was it inquisitive enough? Was it interesting enough? And was it insightful enough? It would be great if you can leave a one-liner feedback as well. Meanwhile, of course, we will follow it up with you. They will reach out to you personally, but then feedback here will be of great help for us. Thank you, Shankar. It's very impressive. Much appreciated. Thanks for your patience and thanks for taking your time out and attending this webinar.
Yeah, so Mr. Shane has again given a comment saying that he believes that this falls under the gray area and it can be made clear after the government gives us more insights. Yeah, that's pretty much what Dana was explaining, Mr. Shane. And it is from Mr. Shahib Mustafa, there was a cloud related question for the online cloud based services.
So correct.
How does it work for that?
What his question was, looks like they are into providing some online cloud services. They wanted to know whether those services come under the purview of VAT. We have to really look into the details of these areas. In one of those first two slides, Meghla was mentioning about what are all those services which is coming under the ambit of VAT and what are exempted. So we may have to have a relook into that slide, or we have to relook into the government services which they have announced as part of the VAT implementation. We have to really look into that. We don't have an information right on hand on this question. Thanks, Shane. Thanks for that feedback. Much appreciated. Anybody else have any other question? Otherwise, we will consider this as coming to an end.
Yeah, so attendees and participants, you can also mail in your questions to caroman@cartech.com. The chat is, if you have any more questions or clarifications after this webinar that comes to your mind, so you can post in your questions to this mail ID, that is caroman@cartech.com. It is posted in the chat as well. So,
thanks, Jyotish. Thanks for your feedback. You say it is informative. Thank you so much.
Yeah.
I think we are almost coming to an conclusion. Once again, I thank you everyone for taking your time out on a working day. And that shows the kind of significance and the prominence that you attach to the VAT requirement, which is again, floated by the government. So we will do our best. We are here to assist you, and we are the experts in this area. So we will also follow it up one by, each one of you personally, and we will, our team will reach out to you. And in case you, should you think that you should reach out to us, and there is an email ID given, and you have the contact details also, our people will be reaching out to you soon. Thank you so much. Have a great week ahead. And we are really looking forward to be associated with you all. Thank you so much. And once again, the panelists, impressive show, Meghla, Shubhangi, Dhanashekaran, and Anantan Tyagarajan for the wonderful coordination, and Prakash and Salai as well, who are the people on the ground doing the sales for our organization. Thank you all. Much appreciated.
Thank you all.
Thank you.
So we are concluding the sessions, please. Thank you so much. Thank you, Shakti. Thank you, Uday.